Director Cotoni, how do you think the financial instruments could be framed in Romania in order to fulfill the objective of financial European instruments?
Now the government and the Ministry of EU Affairs in particular, they have already pre-framed it in the various operational programs. They have been quite innovative when it comes to implementing or proposing financial instruments in the various programs, not only for SME support and innovation, but also energy efficiency and other areas of interest. I guess the next step is indeed to make a clear decision, and this comes out of today's discussion, who is going to implement these instruments. And as Minister Deodorovici has said today, he is not for monopolies, but at the end of the day, he's trying to get the best deal when it comes to mobilizing private investors. And I guess this is the key issue. How can I frame programs in such a way that it becomes attractive to the private market? And here I'm not only talking about the private market of banks, but also other investors. And it's a decision by the government. We are not here to compete with the local markets, but we are here to develop the local markets, be it in the banking sector, be it in the venture capital area. We would very much like to work with the ministry to help them to realize their ambitious strategy, with or without, that's his decision, local and national partners.
The minister also said that he want to implement, to create a new bank of development in Romania, mm-hmm. In order to finance the SMEs and so on. Is this a good idea, or maybe it would be better to access all the financial instruments created by the European Union and European Bank of Investment?
We have many examples in Europe. If you look, for instance, the most prominent is KfW in Germany, and KfW is indeed not only for Germany but also outside Germany making an enormous impact. The creation of a development bank, if again framed well within the legal base in Romania, I guess is indeed a very smart decision. If you look into the discussion today in Europe, the Juncker plan, I mentioned this, the national development agencies are playing a very important role because they know the market, they are rooted into the market, and they can equally mobilize money. So the creation of a national bank at this point in time is potentially a good answer, but I would be warning, insofar it has to be framed well, it has to be embedded in the legal base, and it cannot be subject to any political influence in that on a day-to-day basis. So therefore, generally, we believe in Europe the national development banks are a good addition, can be indeed helping member states to go through crisis, to develop into new areas, as long as they are framed well, their corporate governance is very clear, they are not being influenced by ad hoc decisions but have a clear strategic mission. In this respect, we are trying to work very closely with those banks. As I said, KfW is one of them, but also ICO in Spain or BPI in France, very important partners for us. And if you look at the EIF, for instance, these partners are even shareholders in the EIF. So it shows that, again, we try to team up as opposed to fighting each other.
Maybe we should create a mix of instruments and financial instruments.
The SMEs are indeed the backbone. In Romania in particular, the SMEs are the critical engine for growth, and therefore to right now, as you don't have this national bank, I would be recommending to the Romanian government to use the resources which are there. We as the European Investment Fund and the European Investment Bank are ready to step in to help you, but indeed if this is embedded in a longer strategic plan of development of institutions and thus continuous support of SMEs, we would welcome this.
Director Cotoni, what is your message for the Romanian SMEs?
For the Romanian SMEs, as we have heard today, the biggest problem is not necessarily access to finance, but it is the question, do we have sufficient diversification of financial instruments in the Romanian market? I would be looking, as an SME, also outside resources. That means equity instruments. I would be trying to attract equity instruments into my business. Again, here, the government can do a lot by engaging with structural funds in this area. Because if SMEs are only relying on bank financing, I guess the growth is not going to be that drastic. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.